Hi there. I'm glad you're watching right now. I'm Joep Elfrink. I'm a Dutch second year bachelor student of the program Chemical Science and Engineering. I was asked to tell you something about the beautiful bachelor program. So let's get started immediately. Because what is chemical science and engineering, you might be wondering. Well, it's about chemical science. So it's the science about the composition and structure of molecules and matter, and how this can affect properties and, for example, reactions. And this knowledge and science we are going to use to apply on big issues society and industries might have. So that means that on one side, you will learn about the smallest entities, namely molecules, and can use this to, for example, make a new battery or make a production plant that is the size of a city. So that's my first example of what the chemical engineer is doing. So, for example, you have a large chemical process that is happening or that is being built by chemical engineers. And this process plant is filled with several reactors, all where which reactions are occurring, which have a certain elevated pressure or temperature, for example, to make the reaction as optimal as possible. And all these variables are calculated by chemical engineers. And you might be wondering, why not add the catalyst to that? Because it speeds up the reactions and only produces the molecules we want to have so we can make more money. Then you might be wondering, what kind of catalyst can I use? Or what is the cheapest catalyst I could use? And can it maybe even withstand the extreme conditions that are present in a reactor? All of these are questions that chemical engineers are working with to make sure your reaction is optimized and you can make the most money with it. So yeah, that's basically also something you might be considering. So another example is in membrane technology. And membranes are commonly used to separate gases from liquid, or for example, to clean water to make it drinkable. But also, you might be wondering, how can we make the membrane as effective as possible? And we maybe need a coating for this membrane. And how do fluids even behave in this membrane? Is it separating what it needs to separate? And also, something that's quite interesting is, can we implement it in a bigger process? So that refers back to the first example. Yeah, what you will be seeing is that there's quite some overlap between different aspects you are working with as a chemical engineer. Then my final example is, oh, spoilers. you didn't see that. So my final example is battery technology. In the 21st century, there's an increasing demand in batteries, for example, to power cars with or store more energy. And then you might be wondering, what electrodes or metals for these electrodes can we use, or what's an optimal packaging that we can use for these batteries, and how can this battery even store energy? So, for example, you see the lithium in these batteries. It's a metal that's highly used for this. Or can we produce other, or can we use other metals that are cheaper? These are a lot three examples of a chemical engineer is working with, but obviously there are many more. But these three examples are you'll probably see in this bachelor program as well. So studying chemical science engineering is one thing, but why would you study it at the University of Twente? Well, there's a highly interactive community between teachers and students. So we're not a big study. You will have about 70 students in the first year. So 70, so a zero, no, a seven and a zero, not a one and a seven. There are 70 bachelor students coming in their first year approximately. So that means you can know them easily. And also the connection with your teachers are of a low threshold. So that means you can ask them questions easily and maybe have a drink with them and call them by their first name, which is quite extraordinary. And also for almost 10 consecutive years, we're a top rated bachelor study, which we're pretty proud of. And from this year on, we can call ourselves the best bachelor study in our own topic. So that's something to be really proud of. And also we're one of the few campus universities here in the Netherlands. So that basically means that all the sport facilities and tier facilities are located here on the campus. You can also, there are also some theaters and bars present on the campus. And together with the student housing, it really feels like a small village or living out. There's also a supermarket and a barbershop. So in theory, you couldn't, if you, okay, so in theory, you could stay on campus and live there forever, which is quite special. So 2 years ago, I'm now a second year old student. 2 years ago, I was in the same position as you were, ready to make my study choice. But the only issue was I was really doubting about whether I wanted to do. Almost everything I saw was interesting, and that really doesn't make my choice easier. But I only knew one thing. I didn't want to do a study that was too broad, since that doesn't leave that much room, that much space for specialization. So then I came across chemical science and engineering. What you will be encountering here is that chemistry, physics, mathematics, and engineering is combined in such a ratio that you will learn a lot on all these topics, but also have some room for specialization, which is really nice. So you can really go into the material, but also learn a lot on different topics. That was really nice. And also when I did my student for a day, so I could already see what this bachelor program was like, I found out the ambience was really nice and chill, which only made my choice easier. So yeah, here I am 2 years later. Again, spoilers, I'm really sorry for this. So when you come in our bachelor program, you'll see that each year is divided in four modules. Every module is their own topic. So for example, material sciences or transport phenomena. And all these topics are supplied with the needed amount of lectures and tutorials, also centered around this specific topic. Plus you will have some lab courses and project each module, which really makes sure you learn a lot and it makes sure you get a future-proof education. Also, you see in your third year, there's some room for electives. So that basically means you can do whatever the hell you want. So if you want to do a completely different study, you can do that in this period, but you can also study abroad, but you're already doing that if you come here. So, but okay, so it's possible to study abroad, but you're already doing it. I'm sorry. I hate this program, okay. So about projects, it basically means together with your peers, you're working on one specific project centered around the subject of that module. And in this project, you get to learn how to do a proper research and how can you present your ideas. These are all skills that are highly desired on the job market and make sure you can be the best chemical engineer as you could possibly be. Also, you get to learn how to collaborate with your peers and how to collaborate with people from different cultures, which is also quite interesting to experience. It's you will learn a lot about it. So together, it's quite diverse and it's a future-proof education. So congratulations, you finished your bachelor program 3 years later. What are you going to do now? So you see, most of the students choose to do a master in chemical process engineering or molecular and materials engineering, but it certainly doesn't end there. There are plenty of more options you could choose from. For example, you can choose to do a master in nanotechnology, or maybe you want to become a teacher and you can educate yourself on that topic. But maybe you are not really wanting to do a master study and you want to already work on the job market. That's not really coming, but it's certainly possible. Chemical engineers are highly desired on the job market because of their knowledge and skill package they have. So it's not that common. You have to wait a lot before you get your first job. So possibilities are endless. So this basically concludes my presentation. for you. I hope you enjoyed it. These few minutes were a bit too short, in my opinion, to tell you everything about our program. So I really want you to ask a lot of questions in the chat so I can answer them. Ciao.